back, a naturopath. Thanks for coming back. If we look at nitrogen and carbon, two very important ingredients found, obviously, in the foods that we eat. Experiments were conducted last year by a microbiome researcher at, I think it was Duke University, then eventually, I think Harvard, where this lady's been working. And she basically studied the, she took fecal samples from over 30 animals and looked at the carbon and nitrogen content of these. Very interesting study. You can look it up online. And what they discovered was nitrogen is actually very important for the gut bacteria. When nitrogen was reduced, the bacteria dropped off. When nitrogen was increased, the bacteria seemed to increase a little bit. So what it appears to be is that meat eating, you know, or protein consumption in general, I should say, not just meat eating, because protein, you know, is found throughout nature. You know, nuts and seeds, there are many sources of protein apart from animal flesh that we can eat. So, but the proteins actually contain nitrogen. The nitrogen is quite important. Discoveries are now leading and showing that the gut really benefits from having nitrogen. In fact, bacteria look for nitrogen and they actually feed on mucus in the small intestine and the large intestine. They can feed on bits of mucus to extract nitrogen from it and then convert the residual compound that's left over into various forms, you know, of food for bacteria, which also includes more nitrogen. So they're discovering that, you know, protein is very important for the human microbiome because it confers benefits by producing, you know, this nitrogen load which bacteria thrive on. But of course, more studies have to be conducted before we can find out, you know, to what degree, you know, protein sources, you know, and starch or fiber or carbohydrate-based foods, for example, what benefits all of these confer. But it's exciting to see this new microbiome research coming out. Does it mean to say we need to eat more meat? No, it doesn't at all. You don't need to read that into this study. As I mentioned, more studies have to come out to conclude what we're generally dealing with here. Because one study is not enough to give you information saying this is what you do. Multiple studies around the same topic can often come out with different, you know, different conclusions. So just be careful. But it just goes to show that protein is a very important part of your diet. And that, you know, having a diet high in fruits and vegetables is fine, but you also need to have good sources of protein to have a healthy microbiome. Thanks for tuning in. Click on the link below if you want my free PDF in the description box. Thank you.